If you grow up out South Sydney way, it's sure you're not a swell. And if you leave school with both your ears, you're probably doing well. And they grow up playing rugby league out in the old schoolyard. And they grow up tough cause there's no grass and bitumen is hard. South Sydney boys, you can't do them much harm. Churchill once played with a broken arm. The day they broke John Sattler's jaw, he wouldn't leave the field till the team in red and green had won the shield. Now often Georgie Piggins gets annoyed with what he's got when Coleman's nicking hubcaps from the members' parking lot. And Mario is telling him that Benny hit him first. And Blake's out on the town again working up a thirst. You know, a lot of people reckon that Jeff Fenwick, he can fight. But you know, he gets it easy, cause he fights one bloke a night. But when he's on the football field and wearing red and green, that other Fenwick, Mario, he fights the whole 13. Out South Sydney way, there's not a lot of dough, but they've got a team, it's led by Mario. You wouldn't want to meet them up an alley in the night, but South Sydney people reckon they're all right. You know you're out South Sydney way, you feel it in the air. You'll notice traffic lights are only red and green out there. They've won that trophy 20 times in case you're keeping score. It's a habit with the Rabbits and they plan to win lots more. Clive Churchill, Johnny Sattler, and now there's Mario. Each captain was a battler and a mighty Rabbit-o. And blokes down there in factories or in the corner pub tell the story of the glory of that famous football club. South Sydney boys, you can't do them much harm. Churchill once played with a broken arm. The day they broke John Sattler's jaw, he wouldn't leave the field till the team in red and green had won the shield. Until the team